say that CAT is a playground for engineers. But we have with us today a commerce graduate who in her first attempt went on to bell the CAT with a stellar score of 98.86 percentile. I'd like to welcome Palak Aneja. Hi. Hi Palak.
Hi.
Can you please tell us a bit about yourself?
Okay, so I belong to Delhi and I'm from the commerce background as you mentioned. So after school, I went on to pursue economics honors. And so then after college, I really had no idea what I want to do further in life, not even about MBA. So I just took the placements and I got a job. So currently I'm working at a digital marketing firm as a product specialist. So I've been working for about 1.5 years now. And yeah, so this was my first CAT attempt and I scored 98.86 percentile. And in LRDI, I got 99.6 percentile. And VARC was 96.8 percentile and Quant was 94 percentile.
Okay. So, you know, you come from the commerce background and people usually tell that CAT, engineers have an advantage in CAT, right? Do you ever think you were lagging behind in the race before you started your preparation?
Yeah, definitely. So, once I joined iQuanta and I saw that most of the people who are very, very good at Quant are from the engineering background. So I always felt a little lagging behind, you know. So I knew that I have to brush up a lot on my Quant skills. So that was my focus throughout and I didn't really let that affect me because, you know, it's not about competing with others and it's about how you perform. So, yeah.
Okay. What according to you is the optimum time, you know, to prepare for CAT?
See, there's no optimum time as such, like it's subjective for everyone. But I can say for people who are working and they do not leave their job and continue working. So I think one should start preparing from January or February. And because it is difficult to manage along with your working hours. So like for me, for the initial few months, I only devoted like 2-3 hours every day because it was very difficult to manage. And gradually I could increase to 4-5 hours and I would manage to take out time while traveling to office. And then I had to take some frequent leaves towards the end. And that is when I could actually devote 8-9 hours every day.
Okay. Future aspirants who are viewing this right now, would be eager to understand what was your preparation strategy, you know, how did you approach each section while you were preparing for yourself and how did you look at mocks and analysis?
Okay, so overall strategy was to firstly figure out what the syllabus is about and because there's no fixed syllabus as such. So you just take a look at the past papers and, you know, I did that. I took a look at the past papers because I had no idea how this works. And I was already part of the iQuanta public group on Facebook. So I used to see the sessions that Indrajit sir would conduct. And that is when I started gathering information and kind of, you know, organizing all the work that needs to be done and whatever I need to work on. So I knew that I have to work a lot more on Quant. So my focus initially was to start brushing up my basics in Quant. And then gradually I also started adding like 2 sets of LRDI every day or 1 RC every day. So that was really helpful to, sort of become regular and maintain your scores throughout the 3 sections. And then as in when, again, I joined iQuanta's classes. So I would attend those classes every day. And given my work timings, I only got time to practice on weekends. So that is when I would utilize that time the most. Again, that the share for me for that weekend would be like maximum hours for Quant and a few hours for LRDI and VARC. And then the syllabus got over by June or July. And after that, it was all about mocks. So mocks are very important. And even more important is analyzing them and working on your mistakes and weak areas. I took iQuanta's mocks and then I started taking some sectionals. So there were topic-wise tests also. So that really helped me improve in my quant section. And then I went on to 1 hour sectionals and then again full mocks. And then coming back to analyzing them and actually noting down your weak areas, working on them separately. And then of course, so the first thing was that you know your strengths. So I was always a bit stronger in LRDI. So, you know, the only area that I had to work on there was to see the variety of questions that appear in LRDI. So I think the best thing was to look back at the past questions. And I really didn't have to go to a lot of sources. So Indrajit sir started this initiative called the 250 LRDI. And so there were questions from all sources and all the past papers there. So that was very helpful. And yeah, that was about it. For VRC also, I think initially it was a little difficult to retain the passages and answer the correct questions. And then you left at eliminating two options and you just can't do that. So again, sir launched a VRC revamps course and that was really helpful. So because what I started doing was, like if you left with two options in the end, I would note them down while doing the mock. And when I would go back to analyze, I would see why my answer was right and why the other one was not right or vice versa. So yeah, that was about it.
Okay. So this was, I think, your first attempt to CAD, right? How important was a coaching institute in your preparation? And how much, you know, would you attribute that to your success?
I think I owe it all to iQuanta because I had no idea about the examination or how the system works. So, and again, I was weak in a lot of areas. So I had to take some coaching. And given that I'm working, it was very, very helpful because most of the times, even if I would miss a class, I could just go back and watch the videos and go through the entire class again. And I could get my doubts solved even if I'm studying at 3 a.m. at night. So it was very helpful in that sense also. And then again, the community that has been built is so healthy and it's such a great learning environment that the students within themselves are ready to help each other every time. So that was really nice. Like it never, you know, never made me feel that I'm lagging behind others or like I have to compete with them in a negative sense. It was always positive and healthy. So that's what I loved about it.
Okay. You know, if you look at CAT 2019 statistics, there have been 10 100 percentilers. And all of them are male and from an engineering technology background. What's your take on that?
I don't know. I think engineers do have a sort of edge in the quant section. And that has been proven, though even though I didn't want to believe that. But, and male, because I think again, the proportion of engineers, male engineer students is much greater than the females. But yeah, I think there have been 100 percentilers, female 100 percentilers in the past, and I would love to see someone there.
That's great.
Yeah.
You know, you come from a marketing background, right? Mm-hmm. So is there a certain inclination towards going to marketing? What excites you about this field?
Yeah, I'm certainly very much inclined towards MBA in marketing because, you know, right from when I was in school, I would participate in some competitions like making an ad or creating a strategy or selling a business product and something like that. So I was always interested in, you know, this field. And then I went on to do a similar internship and then now I'm working in a marketing firm. So I love my job right now and I think I would want to do that further.
That's wonderful. So, you know, this journey would not have been simple. I mean, getting to 98.86 in your first attempt itself. So what were some challenges that you faced throughout this journey?
I think the biggest challenge for me was managing it with my job because my work timings are a little messed up and, you know, I have to work in two shifts. So I would just not get time to practice. So there came a time when I sort of felt like, you know, I should maybe either give up the job or try for CAT next year. But then I kind of convinced myself that this should be your one and only attempt and you have to nail this one. So I think staying calm throughout and motivated throughout is very, very important. And you just have to have your priorities set.
So, you know, you would not be studying the entire time, right? There would be an aspect of your day where you would not be studying. What were you doing then?
I would go for dance classes. Oh, so cool. I'm a dancer, and that would just make me extremely happy if I would just go out for an hour, dance and come back. So I would just feel so refreshed, and I could again study with as much efficiency as I had to. It's very, very important, because like you can't just keep studying throughout, and you know, you will come to a saturation point after a certain time. And the right mindset is very, very important, even throughout the preparation time and on the CAT day as well.
What if you had to give some advice, you know, to aspirants coming up for CAT 2020, what are some tips that you'd like to tell them?
I think the major tips would be to, one, find the right coaching institute, and I would recommend iQuanta, of course. And the second is to have your priorities right, because I don't feel that you should just take the exam without preparing, or you know, have your hands full in multiple places. So I think, yeah, that is about it. And just the journey of preparing for CAT should be very healthy, and the right mindset is very, very important. So yeah,
that's great. Thank you so much, Palak. Before I let you go, we have a fun rapid fire round for you.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to ask you a few questions and you can answer them, right? One thing that you'd want to change about yourself?
I want to become fitter.
Okay. What's your biggest strength?
I don't lie.
Okay. If you could spend one day with any celebrity in the world, who would it be and why?
I think Shah Rukh Khan, because I've been his fan for a very, very long time.
Okay. What's your dream MBA college?
It is IIM Ahmedabad, but I've been rejected, so...
Okay. Finally, what's your favorite dish?
That's difficult, but anything that has cheese in it.
Oh, that's lovely. All right. Thank you so much, Palak. And as a token of appreciation, we have something for you. Thank you.
Thank you.